next person coming in. Again, first of all, we did not invite these guests because it's Black History Month. You know what I mean? That's not our thing, guys. But my next, the next guy, I swear this is a true story. He one time he called Dr. Pino and asked him to make, he needed to have a surgery so he could stop being so ashy. Like,
shot fired.
Spoiler alert. The surgery was not successful.
The doctor was like, buy some lotion, you simple motherfucker. Get the fuck out.
Yo, E, how did you ever find that picture of me sitting on the couch with my that action figure with them ashy ass legs and that bumblebee? Yo, I don't know. Did they send me a picture of me with these ashy ass legs sitting on the couch? I'm like, how the hell did you get this picture? I don't even have that picture.
I see candid camera ass picture and shit.
He's worse than the paparazzi, yo.
Yeah, I seen that picture, yo. Don't let that picture come my way, loco. That's just going viral, okay?
Cue the picture.
It looked like he was doing a John Paul Van Damme a kickboxer. fucking chalk picks.
T, how's it going, my brother? What are you sipping on, bro? That should look brown and yummy.
Wait a minute.
The other way. Yeah, there you go.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Homemade whiskey.
Oh, night.
Yo, I still haven't gotten into that, bro. I'm still waiting on the promos bottle and shit.
Yo, is that a segue to shot? Because shot, yo?
Nah, this segment? I'm with it. I'm with it.
It can be. Sure.
I'm with it. Let's go. Tony here.
Marcus, you drinking? Shit. Or are you living the clean life?
No, I'm drinking coffee right now. That's about it.
Oh, yeah, that's a shot right there, baby. Shot of life.
The thing is that Marcus sees Jose, and that memory of that time he got so fucked up is ingrained that even one shot is terrifying.
T, we were talking about his 40th birthday when we went out there to surprise him, how fucking crazy he got.
on that horse.
Oh, shit, bro. This thing brought out the horse.
Damn, I missed the fucking segment. I'm pissed now. I'm going to have to watch it with everybody else.
I gotta find that picture.
The worst
now.
Part about that is I was sober for that one. Because that was definitely the next day.
Yo. Real quick, right? For the people that weren't there, yo, we were fucking the next day, right? It was the next day, like 24 hours later, we went to eat out in steakhouse, the steakhouse place.
Yeah.
Texas Roadhouse, right? Somebody was like, yo, his birthday. Everybody's like, oh shit, his birthday. You know, everybody, all the people get together and we're expecting, yo, they're gonna come happy birthday. The bullshit. Nah, loco. They brought a Roman horse out this bitch. The purpose of this horse is so you have to get on the horse and ride that shit up and down the aisle of the restaurant while people sing happy birthday to you. Right? Oh, no. That was the purpose. I think that was the purpose of the thing.
We were sitting there minding our own business, having a nice steak dinner and some nice conversation. There's a kid at the other table. It's his birthday. So they bring the horse out for him. Then all of a sudden, oh, it's his birthday too. Come on, bro.
Pretty got horse out. This thing got a ride too.
Right.
That's some shit that we do.
At that point, like, you know, you gotta be a good sport. I didn't expect them to take out cameras, but of course.
you didn't expect niggas with cameras?
These are my friends. Yeah.
Like, in 2018, he didn't expect.
Yeah, so I didn't expect anybody to pull out a camera in 2018.
Like, I put
the bolt off the horse and made you look for him.
Yo, T, we didn't even have to fucking argue.
Oh, and you just reminded me. Do y'all remember? Do y'all remember the summer Eddie was on crutches?
Yes, yes, we talked about that shit, yo. Salute.
Fellow salute.
We talked about that shit. Yo, tell me how you remember that story. Yo, we talked about that. We were talking about Seaside, and that sick story came up.
We have a disagreement because I still think this is comedy genius, bro. I stole his crutches. I took them apart.
Oh, yeah. Aniva was telling us that one. Yes.
I stashed all the pieces around the house and then came back in and poured all the screws and bolts on the table.
You were playing, they were saying that we were playing spades or something like that.
Yeah.
And y'all came and put that shit right on the table, all the screws.
See, I had told it that you fucking hit everything and just brought me back like one bolt. Be like, find the rest. It was one bolt with a ransom note.
Good luck, sir. Good luck.
Fucking made a scavenger hunt for you, kid.
Yeah, first clue.
He's like, you a pirate, right? X marks the spot, nigga.
But wait. I was in the bathroom with this fool when he cut his cast off.
Oh, get out of here.
Yeah, he had a knife, a saw. I don't know what that was. I mean, he had something, and we were sitting in this dude's bathroom sawing away at his cast. We finally get it off, and his like left leg was about 35 pounds, and his right leg was about 12.
It was about 350.
And then he after he got the cast off, because he wanted to take it off so he could break dance.
That sounds like you, okay? That just sounds so much.
Sounds
like
accurate.
My windmills are not fucking coming accurate, guys. You know what I mean? One leg is dragging.
No, he's absolutely lying because he damn sure knows I was hitting windmills with the cast on.
he no doubt, he definitely was, but it was kind of impeding his movement. So he's like, nah, I gotta get this.
He wasn't as aerodynamic with the cast, right. But with the 12-pound leg, it was flying through the air. It was slicing through. It was just
the nigga damn near took off.
So he had one leg just flapping. There was no muscle definition whatsoever. It was like a noodle, and the other leg was straight and solid.
Tissue development and shit.
Oh my god!
Okay. Calcium.
You know how people tie racks in the back and pick when there's something hanging off the back? That's how my leg was and shit.
That's an inflatable dog, okay? That's got the car dealership. Yo, Mark, but we was talking about that time in Seaside when somebody pushed his wheelchair into the fucking store, like full speed.
Now that I have to apologize for.
Somebody is right here.
Nah, bro. We gotta wait for fucking Tone to come back because he was part of that shit too. He needs to apologize too.
Now that I'm at this age, man, I've realized how dangerous and reckless it was.
Not that I almost died. Okay, not that I almost got shot.
So we did that shit in Wilbur Center too, bro. We did that shit in Wilbur Center too. Like, I think I rolled him up a ramp and then walked away one day. Like, when he was in the wheelchair, I rolled him up to the top of the ramp and then just let him just kind of roll down backwards and shit.
Whose idea was to give you a wheelchair? That's the person whose problem.
It was his.
Oh, that's right. Because
he had the crutches going through the mall, bro. It was
the
like,
setup. He knew what he was going to do to you. He planned that shit out. That was premeditated, Marcus.
He has this bit laid out for the last month, bro.
Yeah, sketches and shit.
So he got camera set up. I don't even know about
it. Ah, shit. Yeah, but I had the Heelys on and I was fucking going and then I got them going and shit.
Yeah, you know what was another funny topic that we had talked in the past? We were talking about the first time we had smoked, right? You remember when's the first time you smoked?
I remember the first time I smoked and then it actually took way longer for me to actually catch that first high. But
me.
He's one of those guys that didn't know how to smoke and shit. He'd be like,
nah. Like Nah, son, it took me like multiple smoke sessions. Like, not everybody gets high their first time doing it. It took me like 6 or 7 times. And yeah, then I was like, oh, wow, this is amazing. Yeah.
Wait, weed then.
Wait. 6 or 7 sit-ins or hits?
This is the first time
six or seven times, like smoking a blunt with somebody. Yeah, before I was finally like, oh, this is what it's supposed to feel like. And then, like, yeah, that shit fucking rocked me. But, like, prior to that, you know, I'm like, smoking it, not really feeling anything. But at that time, not knowing any better, so pretending, oh, yeah, I'm so high and shit. But,
placebo.
Yeah, definitely. But then I can't even, like, I remember a few times a house party in Brunswick. That one, I definitely felt like I lost a pivotal brain cell in the war on drugs. Like, the drugs were like definitely winning at that point. Right.
Did you go to Dare in middle school?
Oh, yeah, of course.
Do you have a t-shirt?
Everybody had to go to some kind of of course. Oh, everybody's shit. Got a Dare shirt somewhere.
You see, no, I don't got a Dare shirt. I never got a Dare shirt.
I never got
it. Eddie never got one either. That's what me and Ed was saying. This is why this shit didn't work for us.
Y'all didn't know then. All right, then. So it's understandable. So y'all didn't know and shit.
They made us definitely felt a Dare, but just never got the t-shirt.
Oh, okay. Oh, damn.
We sat through the classes, just they never gave us one.
So
damn, that's discriminatory, bro.
Yeah, we got a keychain.
A keychain. A keychain was a bottle opener, okay? Did you see what the fuck you're talking about? The keychain was a bottle opener.
With no keys and shit. Oh, shit.
What were you saying, T?
So, with the house party in Brunswick, right? Was that the one where, one thing where, like, a house party, we smoked, and then somebody was playing PlayStation, the original joint, and somebody had
O'Neal's.
Yeah, O'Neal's. Yo, that was, what we smoking out of an African booty, it was like an African statue.
They had all, like, son, they had all kinds of shit going around, man. I was like, God.
Oh, I forgot about that. But, he had, like, the African figurine woman and shit. The titties out.
Yeah, like I had forgot about that one too. Yeah, bro. Yo, but yeah, man, that was that night. It was like,
the crazy thing is about that night is Mark's driving us home, right? And we driving, and nobody's really paying attention, but we doing like 17 miles an hour on like Route 18, and it's like we start counting the lines on the road. Yo, that night was...
Yeah, I was counting the lines on the road on the way home, bro. I was definitely counting the lines.
One, jeez. One and a half.
Two and a half. Wait, that one's a long one.
For a little bit, bro.
Count is two.
Yeah.
He had an apartment in New Brunswick, though. For you to not don't know, Brunswick Rutgers, right? In the fucking... In the middle of campus area. You know what I mean? So it was a college dorm, pretty much, eventually, what the fuck he ended up renting out, right?
Yeah,
we got wind of this. ManorHeads will fucking go in your house and take it over, people. If you invite one, you invite us all.
Yeah. 10 are coming, bro.
10 are coming, okay? Because we don't know what we're walking into.
shit.
Yeah, those nights got crazy in there, yo.
You invite one of us. That's our party at your house.
Facts. House party at such and such address. Everybody.
Right. Yo, Marcus. I touched on this with Bear last time about how he didn't live in the manor, but obviously he's a manor head. You know, so are you. You know what I mean? You you lived in the manor, basically. You know, always there hanging out with us and shit. What would your take of the manor be? You know what I mean? Like, what kind of people were there? What'd you look for in the manor?
Shit, it started out because y'all had the bigger basketball court. Because both of them were small. Like, if I didn't want to go to the height.
I was just like,
yeah, it's like, and I mean, to be like, if I was trying to play sports, that's where it was happening. because back over on Judy, like, we all know what was going on Judy with like everybody our age. So if I was just trying to just not be, if I was trying to be doing some other shit, I had to be in the manor.
But they had a lot of sports going at all times, y'all. There was something all time. Kickball, baseball, basketball, anything.
Yeah. Marty was always willing to throw you a football.
Facts. We talked about Marty. Yeah, you went through the football training camp too with Marty?
Well, I mean, I didn't go through a training camp, but I was definitely out there. Definitely out there.
Were we talking about that? Lino?
Yeah, with Lino, yeah.
It was fucking, they were cracking me up. Because I wasn't there for the Marty era, right? Or I was still playing with Armando and Lino fucking in the woods and shit like that. You know what I mean? I still had play clothes, you know. I didn't have real clothes on. I didn't put jeans on yet.
So. You were still crashing cars together back then, bro. Like, just sitting on the stoop, just crashing cars together.
Playing trucks. We told him we were playing football and it wasn't soccer. And he was like, you know what? I want no parts.
You guys don't even know what football is. You guys don't even know.
No part of football. Oh yeah, I love football. Yeah.
We told him we're gonna play. Why do you need football? He came out with cleats and shit.
Yeah. Oh, look, I'm in shorts,
shin guards.
Yeah. I'm in Umbro shorts too. You know they used to be bad shorts back then too. I'm like over here. I'm like, what?
The thing he told people putting on gloves. He's like, wait, what are the gloves for? We don't need our hands.
Wait, you don't use your foot?
Forget it, okay.
So you gotta tackle people. Nah,
that's foul. That is a foul.
Oh, tackle my guy.
Through stages of everything, man. We went through stages of baseball, basketball, football, fucking kickball, fucking manhunt, sideways baseball.
Baseball
shit.
You know, one thing that sticks with me, we're playing with the kids still, it's the what do you call it? automatic baseball, right? You don't run, right? You just hit in it. If you catch it with the first hop, you're out, kind of shit. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
I still play that shit with the kids, yo. That's the best. That was the best. The shit, all you gotta do is hit, you don't even gotta run.
Yeah,
motherfuckers yell at you, yo. You're in second base and you don't fucking run, motherfucker. I'm like, I'm not supposed, am I supposed to run right now?
That's the kind of sport, the one you barely have to run in. You should see him play soccer. That nigga's immobile.
Facts. But I get shit done.
When Memphis first got to the manor, we had to have a buddy system, and Jose used to have somebody chase him and tell him when to run on the bases and shit all the way. Go now.
It was a training camp, yes. And then you introduced punchable kickball on top of that shit? Fuck out of here. Y'all motherfuckers. Y'all go on.
I remember... one night in our 20s, having a giant game of manhunt running through the manor as like grown ass adults, bro. Like,
we was going to people's fucking balconies on the second floor too high and shit.
Yeah,
we going to people's balcony second floor, then jumping in the air conditioner and going in the roof.
Yeah.
Ah, oh, shit.
Can you imagine you're 3 a.m. you fucking sleeping on your head, dunk, you're running through the fucking.
People called the cops on us twice, bro. People called the cops on us twice, and I don't blame them now. Shit.
Twice at night.
Yeah, I remember I hit.
I wish I would see some 20-year-olds running around outside right now.
I hit on a balcony once while a family was watching Batman in their living room and shit. The Batman with Arnold Schwarzenegger is the ice dude and shit.
Freeze.
Yeah, back then and shit. So I'm like sitting there watching the movie. Everybody's running around downstairs. I'm laying on this guy's balcony enjoying the film. With
like, that TV.
Popcorn and shit.
Nice size TV.
Yeah.
And like, hey, don't, can you put the volume up? Hey. Volume, man.
Yo, pass that popcorn.
Yeah, is that an allegedly? Can we get sued for that? Can they got to put allegedly?
he wasn't a trespasser.
I stole their cable.
Should have told me they were watching Batman. I would have went back and stole their TV because they didn't deserve it for watching that track.
Dang, what you got against Batman? God.
That was top of the line back then, though.
The one with Arnold Schwarzenegger?
That was terrible.
That was the one you see once, maybe twice.
The penguin.
And that was the Clooney Batman, wasn't it?
Yeah.
That was the penguin Batman, though. No? The penguin.
Nah.
Nah,
That was bad. That was like
that was Batman Returns. Yeah, Batman Returns. The the Clooney Batman. That might be like the one of the worst superhero movies I've ever seen. Like,
what's your favorite Batman movie? What's your favorite Batman one?
Oh, I think the best superhero movie of all time is The Dark Knight.
Dark Knight. The best Batman to me is The Dark Knight.
Yeah.
I think that's the best superhero movie, period.
And pretty much all agree on that.
I remember seeing that at Martin's house. I went to Martin's house for something, and they were in the middle of it. And I was like, yo, this shit is dope. And they restarted the movie, and we saw it. I left, and I bought it. I went to, like, Sam Goody or whatever. And I bought the movie because I was like, this shit is fucking amazing. That shit was
like, dope. We're like 20 minutes from the end of the fucking movie and shit. It's just an excuse to watch it again. Shit. Yeah. Come in. No, we'll restart it. Restart.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't think I got my shit on Blu-ray, Ken.
Yo, that's one of those movies I could watch over. If it's on, I'll stop and finish watching it and shit.
I feel the same way.
Yeah. That one, and there's another one that I can't, like, it's always good. Fucking Shooter with Mark Wahlberg, for some reason. Yeah. And that shit's on.
Oh.
I just fucking watch
Shooter.
It.
I don't think I've seen that one. Shooter?
Yeah.
He's a sniper? Mark
he gets
straight. It has to do with a sniper,
One of the movies.
That was Mark Wahlberg's last good movie. That was his last good movie, bro.
Let me pull up his catalog real quick. That was his
last. Put it this way, it was good enough that Amazon made a TV show about it.
True, which was actually pretty good too. I mean, that was a good show too, the one with Ryan Phillippe. Yeah,
I haven't watched it yet. I'll check it out.
Yo, I like Spencer Confidential. That was okay.
Which one?
Spencer Confidential on Netflix.
Oh, the one with Mark Wahlberg. Oh, okay.
That was funny. I mean, those are like hip action flicks with witty lines and shit. You know what I mean?
But didn't the others come out after Shooter? So I would say the others is the last good movie he's been in.
That's pop.
You talking about the other guys? Not
the other guys.
Yeah, the other guys.
If I remember correctly, the other guys and the Departed both came out before Shooter.
The other guys was 2010. No, the other guys was 2010. The Shooter was 2007.
Okay.
Well, check out the
Shooter. The Other Guys was his last movie then.
The Other Guys was funny.
The Other Guys was good.
Yeah. He did Transformers. He did Entourage. Ted. How about Ted? You don't like Ted?
That was good. Yeah, he's got some stuff.
Okay. All
right. Daddy's Home.
Fucking Mark Wahlberg's millions on the line here and shit.
I like Mark Wahlberg as an actor. I don't dislike him.
Daddy's Home 2.
But him as an actor and movie entirely is two different things.
Well, no, I mean, he's just had a run of some really bad movies.
Yeah, anybody seen Max Payne?
The video game was good.
The more I think about him, the more I like it. The more shit I do like. He had that one movie was about real life, about that oil rig in the ocean that went down. That was pretty good.
Daddy's Home.
You know what I mean? The Big Hit back in the day, that was pretty good.
Yeah, but that was Deepwater Horizon. Like, he's got a
2016.
I thought that was all right.
Oh, see, that's even later, Deepwater Horizon. But I didn't think.
How about Patriots Day? With I think that was the Boston bombing. Yeah, the Boston Marathon bombing.
I didn't see that.
You didn't like him on that?
I saw it. I don't know if I saw it.
I don't typically enjoy watching historical retellings of stuff I was alive for.
Why?
Like, if I've seen it, like, because I saw it. Like,
I'll remember it different than what you're trying to show me.
So, yeah, like.
But I look at it as seeing other people's point of view kind of thing. Like, maybe they, like, the new Biggie thing. Are you going to watch the new Biggie documentary?
Well, I mean, that's a doc. I mean, I watched the doc, but I don't necessarily want to watch like a drama. Like, when you watched the Biggie biopic, did you learn anything new?
No.
Stuff that you already knew because you were
at 17. And that was my next question.
I've never seen the Biggie or Tupac movie because I feel like that's somebody else's telling of them. So, Like, my telling of that is probably better than their telling of that.
You don't want to ruin it.
That would be a better movie, like, 30 years from now than it is right now. You know what I mean?
Yeah, but you're right. Nobody's telling me something new that I haven't heard of yet, right? Yeah. I usually do it for the music because that shit ends amped up. On my birthday, yeah. I watched, remember Streets is Watching? JC, I watched that shit for, it was the best thing, yo. I lit up, chilled back on my couch and put that shit on a full volume. I'm uncomfortable. I make uncomfortable situations, right? Remember that scene, the sex scene with the girls are fucking licking each other down the fucking stairs and shit like that?
Yeah.
The whole family's in the living room, kid. I'm over here like that.
This is art, people. This is art.
Streets is Watching is not a movie. Streets is Watching is the music videos fucking stapled together with a couple scenes. Here.
That's right. That's right. With Dame Dash talking in the background and shit.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, it might as well be Moonwalker by like Michael Jackson or something.
Moonwalker.
Yeah, that's pretty much what it was. Hey, listen, I'm gonna say something that might be controversial.
Yes, we'll bet that.
I'm ready.
With that.
It's still gonna be on the lines of movies, but I kind of think Scarface is overrated.
Ooh, explain yourself.
Please.
Tell me how or why.
I mean, I don't get why it's everybody's favorite movie. It's not that. Is it really that good of a movie?
Yeah, but it tells you
movie, but it's a great movie.
It tells you the story of a fucking immigrant that came from nothing. He was on balls. Look where he got.
Yeah, now, I can't appreciate that. But
let me put my perspective, because when I saw it, it was the most gangster shit ever. It from a guy coming from nothing to making it all the way to the top of the fucking fucking drug dealing hierarchy. And it was fucking probably the most gully shit I've ever seen. A dude getting, chopped up in a fucking bathroom.
Yeah,
it was a
chainsaw.
And,
yeah.
It came out 83.
There's elements there that I had never seen because I was so young,
It came out 83.
When it came
How old
out,
are you?
I was like, wow, it's so powerful. So to me, that's kind of why it holds so much weight.
Marty, it came out in 83. How old were you?
83? 83. Shit, I was 4, but I probably didn't see it till 80.
I was in the fucking rag. 86? I was still in the rag in the fucking in the dresser, kid.
I saw it on
VHS it later,
when they had two VHSs. Mm. You had to switch to the next one to see part two.
I saw it as a teenager, but then as I watch it, even though it came out in 83, the Godfather came out prior.
Yep.
I don't know.
Like, I understand what you're saying, Marcus. Like, as far as cinema goes, it's a badly written, badly acted, badly shot movie. But if you tell rap niggas about this shit, just like they'll describe it like Martin said, he's like, yo, this nigga came from nothing. He shot his way to $1 million in a fucking in a mansion. Like it's a street Bible.
But there's a lot of other gangster pics I would watch well before I watched Scarface.
And your feeling about Scarface, I kind of feel about The Godfather. Like, I think it was an okay movie, but I'm not wowed how everybody else is wowed about it.
The Godfather dropped jewels on you.
It definitely drops jewels.
And I think that was the purpose of that movie. But go ahead, Anubis.
Real quick, but I got the comment that Merck said about poorly filmed, I think it was you said, or badly filmed. You got to understand where the film's coming from, right? It's like 80s.
Well, they had a lot of problems with that.
Yeah, and it's really the era, right? So if you go back to Saturday Night Live or Saturday Night Fever, right? The movie with what's his name?
John Travolta.
You watch that movie, it's like, okay, it's a little trash. I mean, okay, the dancing and the fucking music, the soundtrack made the movie, and in the era, it was like, oh, that's a great fucking movie. But if you look at it, it's like the story is so thin, veil thin. As far as the storytelling of Scarface, though, like the blood, the true grit, what, Marty Mo said about the hacking the motherfucker off in the bathtub, and then like downstairs, you got the dude trying to pick up the girls, off the avenue. Like that storytelling, and then like the filmography of moving from there, going back to that bloodshed that's happening. Like, there's mad fucking parts of the movie that you'd say, like, damn, that shit wasn't done, and it was done right for that time. I don't know. I'm a De Palma follower too. Not like he's the best director, but you know, his movie telling in other movies kind of follows the same format too.
I get that point as it was at a time, because the 80s Miami, 70s, late 70s, 80s in Miami was a fucking war zone, kid. It was
everywhere.
Right, the cocaine cowboys area kind of shit, right? I liked that movie because it was like, oh, it's almost a documentary. My fault, Mark. What are you going to say?
And I don't know. I just kind of felt like that if it had been a little more developed, I probably would have enjoyed it more. Like even just I didn't feel, as far as telling a story, there wasn't enough detail in telling that story. Mm. So that's where I was just like, I was never drawn into Tony the way I was drawn into, say, I was never drawn into him the way I was drawn into, like, let's say, Carlito. Yeah.
Carlito's way.
True.
Like,
all right, so favorite gangster movie.
That's
favorite
writing.
Favorite gangster movie. Everybody name one. Tony, T, you start. Favorite gangster movie that you could watch over and over again whenever it's on.
My cousin Vinny.
It counts. Marty.
Yo, I can't fucking think of the name of it right now, man.
Act it out, loco.
In the beginning, there's a little boy and shit, and his father's telling him, "Don't fuck with the mafia. Don't fuck with the mafia." But he fucks with the
Bronx
mafia.
Bronx Tale. Bronx Tale's a dope movie.
I like the Bronx Tale.
That's a good one.
Marcus.
That's tough, man. That's tough.
I'm saying you shit it on Scarface. You gotta have a go to one.
Yeah, honestly, with everything I just said about Scarface, this is gonna sound super hypocritical.
Wait, son,
say Scarface.
I fucking love Paid in Full, bro. I fucking love Paid in Full. Like.
Cameron, Mackay
Pfeiffer, and back to the first part of the episode when I got hit with that grab and run, I was definitely sitting in the store like motherfucking Mitch in the car, bro.
And this stuff,
man. I'm about to be on some straight murder shit, eh?
Everyone, whoever's wronged me is dead.
Fucking dead,
B. Straight up dead, B.
Oh shit!
That was a good
niggas get robbed every day, B.
Yo,
yeah.
Ed, what's yours, Rocco?
Fuck, I'm really stuck between Boys in the Hood and Casino. Those are like my
Casino.
Casino's a good one.
Casino's the shit.
Boys in the Hood is fucking clearly classic.
Yeah, boys. Yeah, man.
That should be everybody's fucking top.
It's pretty, I can never get
Boys in the Hood, Casino. I'm like, I love them both.
It depends on what mood you're in. If you're in the heist mood or if you're in the hood mood.
I mean, because they're both kind of heavy watches too, man.
Yeah.
They're emotional. They take a lot out of you to watch.
For different reasons, but because
Anubis.
How long?
I love The Godfather. Love the fucking Godfather. But I can't say one of them is better. I think I love them all three together. But if I had to say one, it's a toss up between Goodfellas and The Untouchables. I like the storytelling of The Untouchables, right?
Okay.
But The Goodfellas is that fucking raw footage of, like, you know, the guy in the trunk and the bump and what the fuck is that sound? And just, like, again, storytelling. Then you open up the trunk and the last thing you think is the fucking guy. I thought he had a fucking flat tire in the beginning of the movie.
Yeah. Goodfellas is always a movie that I go to.
Yeah.
It has a comedy, crime, and the whole nine, right? Blow is another one that I like.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Blow is fucking a dope movie, but I always hate the end of it, right? I always want to see him win.
Yeah. Kind
of shit, right? I want to see him win. All the they never fucking win.
No matter how many times you play it.
No matter how many times I fucking play it, they don't fucking... I literally stop the movie before it gets to that point. Like, I see up, I literally have stopped the movie at that point and be like, I'm good.
That's what right I do. As I do that,
Carlito's Way too. Carlito's Way is another one. As soon as he's up there, you're like, all right, I'm good. Let me shut it off.
As soon as he makes it to the train platform, I'm like, all right, this is another movie. They made it.
I still have an issue with Penelope Cruz to this day because of the movie Blow. Like it's really hard for me to watch anything else that she's been in.
Because, why is that?
Because she was the wife that got George arrested at the
car,
bro. Yeah.
So you hate her personally for a film she was
don't blame
in.
Her for the blow, bro. The blow made her
but to be honest, I was like, damn, she's a really good actress. Because even all these years later, like, I still have a problem with her getting Boston George arrested.
That's true. I never thought of it that way.